I knew it. I knew it.
What was weird about this?
Sorry, Max's mom.
It felt wrong. It felt like it felt so twisted.
I talked to you yesterday.
Hello, Ignacio Serricchio here, Don West from Lost in Space. The cast and I, we've been super busy promoting the last season of Lost in Space on Netflix, doing video conferencing. You never know what to expect with these press junkets. I got bored and I decided to play just a little prank on Max and Mina with the help of our amazing fake host, Zach.
Hi, Ignacio.
And these telepresence robots. We're gonna put my poor friends through the worst interview ever.
Welcome to Sci-Fi IRL. I'm your host, Zach Broussard. We've got the 411 on all the zeros and the ones. And today, we've got the stars of Netflix's Lost in Space. My first guest, you're gonna love him. He's Mr. Danger Will Robinson himself, Mr. Max Jenkins.
Hey guys, this is crazy. I've never done anything like this before.
A little further back, Max?
Okay.
Okay, you're off the carpet. You need to come back forward a little bit.
Come back forward.
Stop. A little forward. Stop. To your left. A little further. 1 second, hold. And we're good. Lock it in. All right, I'm sitting with Mr. Max Jenkins from Lost in Space. How you doing, Max?
Hey guys, I'm doing great. I'm glad to be here.
Pretty cool set, right?
Yeah, this is nuts. This is totally nuts. I've never done anything like this before.
I wonder whose show has more high-tech technology, right?
I think it might be you guys, to be honest.
I hope so. So, man, tell me about your experience filming season three.
Yeah, you know, season three, it's the final season of Lost in Space, of our version of Lost in Space. And, you know, I kind of grew up on that show. So it's pretty, it's kind of mind-boggling to know that we're done.
What's your favorite sci-fi series other than Lost in Space? Doesn't have to be TV, could be movies.
That is a hard one. I'm a Trekkie, for sure. Obviously Star Wars. I actually got the chance to meet Dave Filoni at the Saturn Awards.
Okay, you're going into season three. Every season you guys go to these crazy worlds. Is there any world that you're excited for people to see in season three?
There are some pretty amazing planets that we'll see. And of course, you know, with every season comes more and more mythology about robots.
Yes, we love the robots here. I mean, this show is all about tech. We love the robots, okay? I mean, obviously, look at you. You're a robot right now, Max.
My dream come true.
That's right. Now, was it hard acting in a show with so much science?
Yeah, I mean, science is always changing. We're always discovering new things. With every new episode that our crazy writers decided to try and create, we had to really make sure that what we were doing was scientifically accurate.
Well, they didn't try too hard.
We brought in a real consultant who helped us make it as realistic as possible.
I mean, are they checking these people's credentials at all? I don't know, man. Just because, like, for some, like, tech fans, I feel like, I'll just talk about, like, the pilot right out of the gate. Like, the Jupiter 2 lands in that water, right? And it's freezing. It keeps freezing on Judy. But if it was that cold, everyone who had their masks off would also be freezing because we're, hello, made of water.
Yeah, I didn't even think about that.
Yeah, it's just like one
I'm
of those things.
I'm not a scientist,
like,
obviously.
I try not to let it take me out of the show, but sometimes it's like, all right, come on. And then you're like, you're going and looking up all that, like, magnesium from the vein. Mm-hmm. And that couldn't exist like that in the real world. Like, it wouldn't be in the open like that. It changes, like, immediately when it's open.
Maybe,
I mean, I don't know. I guess you could just say,
it's
like,
a special
alien
kind
planets.
Of magnesium. Maybe yeah. It's a special kind.
Yeah, alien magnesium. The science is it's a little wishy-washy in the show. I think it's so funny that we all have no idea how computers work. We just like somebody made it, and it obviously makes our life better. We love it, but it's like, how do they work?
You know, I understand the theory behind it, and I understand why it works, but Bluetooth.
I don't trust Bluetooth.
Really?
What is it?
I mean, I couldn't tell you.
I want to say it's magic. I know it's not magic, but it feels like witchcraft.
Totally. Absolutely.
Even down to like simple things for me, it's like the robot, okay, is like super intelligent. He's got all these skills, but he talks at like a one-year-old verbal level.
The robot is learning to speak through Will Robinson, and you know, there's some stuff that will be revealed in the third season of the history of robots. It's
walking through the set. What doesn't even make any sense? What's going on? Max, I'm very sorry. This is weird. I have like a little bit of a phobia about tech stuff. Robots, really. Which is very funny talking to you.
Very funny. Yeah.
What's the machine in your home that you were most scared of?
Probably the blender. I'm gonna be honest.
Sharp. Very sharp.
I'm always worried that it's gonna just like explode if I hit it, if I turn it up too high.
I think what I don't, because blenders aren't self-blending, like you need to press a button to do it. It's all this like, you walk into a room and a thing powers on. I don't like that.
I don't mind it because it saves me a bit of extra work.
This is what's gonna lead to the end. That ease of use that you want, just sort of like, this is just gonna, it makes my life better. Whatever, I'll give him my data. Self-driving cars. It's not hard to drive a car.
Being a car guy myself, I don't really like the self-driving cars.
Thank you, we can meet in the middle on that. Yeah, I don't like any, basically a robot, a machine, should have to ask permission to do anything. I don't like it. I don't want to be an adult man telling a kid what to Google, but basically the singularity is the theory that technology is advancing faster and faster and faster. It's exponential at this point. And at some point it's going to surpass human understanding because it's going to start essentially self-evolving. I'm exhausted. I'm sorry.
No, totally. I'm sorry. I completely get you.
We should not trust these robots. like one good one doesn't make up for all of these insane ones. They're trying to kill you, Max.
I can't imagine. I feel like it's a cool idea, but I feel like we're still in control for now.
You think we're in control?
I think we're in control.
I think, personally, that we keep adding on new tech. And we think we, oh geez. Who's controlling this? I thought it was powered down.
Oh, buddy. Yo, buddy, you.
I knew it. As soon as I saw it, I knew it from the first moment.
Dude.
I could smell it from a mile away. I saw it, I knew it was gonna be you.
Why?
Because who else on the cast would it be? Other than me, what? Who else would do that? It just felt, it felt wrong. It felt like, it felt so twisted. It was so awkward. I was like, are we seriously like bad-mouthing the show? Because like, listen, I got stories, but like.
Was your mom wondering like, what the hell is?
Yes, my mom is back here like going like, what the?
Are you there? Were you weirded out by all this?
Mom, come over here.
Sorry, Max's mom.
No.
Were you weirded out by all this?
Completely.
What was weird about
utterly.
This?
Oh my God. I was like having a heart. I feel wrong doing this. Like I was like, this feels wrong. And then as soon as like the third time the robot came by, I was like, this is Ignacio. This has to be Ignacio.
Maximus, I'm pranking Mina next, so shut it.
All right, I'll keep it shut. But Ignacio, let me tell you something, man. You told me you were gonna get me sometime when I wasn't expecting it. Same back at you, bro. I'm coming at you hard next time.
Welcome back to Sci-Fi IRL. I'm your host, Zach Broussard, and we're talking with two of the stars of Netflix's Lost in Space.
Hello, my name is Ignacio Serricchio. I play Don West.
Hi, my name is Mina Sundwall, and I play Penny Robinson.
What I think we'd like from each of you guys is to get just like directly to your camera, just a very brief, you're watching Sci-Fi IRL, check out Lost in Space season 3, December 1st. Get one of those? Okay, we're going in two. Mina.
You're watching Sci-Fi IRL and
I'm sorry.
No, it's all good.
It's just good. They're really picky. Sci-Fi IRL.
Sci-Fi
IRL. And whenever you're ready, 3, 2, and go.
You're watching Sci-Fi IRL.
I didn't love it. Just the way we said it, Sci-Fi IRL, and louder.
You're watching Sci-Fi IRL, and Lost in Space comes out December 1st on Netflix.
Awesome. Did we get it? We got it. I'm a huge fan of the show. This is one of those series that means a lot to a lot of people. I'll start with you, Ignacio. How's it feel to be part of a remake of a classic television show?
We definitely didn't take it lightly. Kind of always keeping in mind, you know, the weight that the original carried.
Same question to you, Mina.
Well, like Ignacio said, I mean, we knew that we had really big shoes to fill when we started it. I think we kind of went down a different path for sure. It's modernized, but they've pulled some of the elements that I really love from the original, like the hope and the love of the family.
Yes. It must have been pretty cool to film the show in Honolulu, right? That must have been nice.
I wish.
What? Where did you guys film?
No, we filmed mostly in Vancouver, a little bit in Alberta, a little bit in Iceland.
There's a lot of differences in this new version. Both series involve essentially this ship crashing in a mysterious place. In the new one, the ship is called the Jupiter 2. The old one, it's called Oceanic Flight 815. A little different. Obviously, in the old one, it's like not a new planet like this. The old series dealt mostly with, it didn't really deal with science until they introduced the Dharma Initiative a little later on in season 2. And I feel like at that point you're just like hinting at like this potential of science, but it's more about the mystery of these unique locations. And I feel like really this show is all about science.
Yeah, a lot of it.
There is a lot of science, which I love as a tech guy. I love tech. So basically, I understand there was a lot of casting choices in the new one that might be slightly different than the original. Did you guys grow up watching the original series?
No, I did, yes, I did. I watched the original. There's an actor that I was a huge fan of.
Which one? Hurley?
Who?
The actor Hurley?
I don't know who that is. No, for me it was Guy Williams.
I don't know who that is.
The guy who plays the dad.
Yeah, okay, the dad.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know the dad. Yeah, but I can sort of see how everyone maps out based on the original. Like, I can see that Ignacio's character is clearly meant to be the Sawyer. Like, he's like the cool guy. He's got swag. Who do you think Penny is supposed to be from the original?
Sorry, what do you mean in terms of being from the original?
Which character from the original do you think Penny best represents?
A Penny? I mean, I think Penny.
Okay. Why do you think that the writers of the new series did not put in a smoke monster? One of the biggest, I mean, I'd say it was like the central point of the original series was all of these cast members dealing with the smoke monster. What is the smoke monster? Then it's revealed to be the man in black, so the man in black is the smoke monster. It was a little confusing, but if you're a fan of the show, you just accepted it. But I thought it was interesting that they didn't include a smoke monster in this series.
The original had
Dr. Smith is the like the bad, you know, like the antagonist. I don't remember a smoke monster from season one.
Yeah, in the original, no, it's he's out there the whole time. And I know it's an old show, but the graphics looked really cool for, I mean, what is it like? I don't know, 20 years old at this point. It looked surprisingly realistic.
The original's from the late 60s.
I think the original is from like 2003.
The original show is from the late 60s.
The original was like such a big part of my like college experience. Like me and my friends would all get together and just like, it was the first like kind of community watching I'd do just like as an adult. It was so cool.
Lost in Space?
Well, the original, Lost.
Oh! Yeah, right.
This is the remake, Lost in Space.
No.
No, this is based on a show from the late 60s of the same title.
Yeah. You're thinking of another show.
It's not based on the ABC show Lost.
Oh, Honolulu makes so much more sense right now. That makes so much more sense. Yeah. I wondered why they would film that in Honolulu.
Let's pretend this never happened. I think we're gonna kind of wrap this up. First of all, I just want to say thank you guys very much for taking time out of your busy schedule to promote the series. Am I the, I feel like, are these normally, how, is this going okay?
Dude, this is fucking ridiculous. This is ridiculous.
What's ridiculous? It's like,
well, because now I have to tell her that we've been pranking her this whole time.
You, I was gonna say it halfway through. I was like, I feel like I'm being pranked. You suck. How did you not tell me before? Oh my God.
You realize how wonderful and gentle and what a good soul she is that she felt so bad for you.
You gave me way too, you humanity. Gave me way too many line reads.
Mina, I love you. I had to.
Oh my God, I'm gonna be embarrassed for the rest of my life.
That might have been the worst interview ever, but please check out Lost in Space, only on Netflix.
December 1st.
I'm gonna get you, Ignacio. I'm serious, man. I'm planning it.
Absolutely, you should watch Lost in Space.
Louder!
A little low. You're coming in a little low.
You should watch